Welcome to H2K Infosys. H2K Infosys is a e-verify business based in Atlanta, Georgia, United States. We provide 100% job-oriented, instructor-led, face-to-face, true live online software training programs. It also includes access to cloud test lab with software tools. We provide live project for you to work on. We also provide assistance with mock interviews, resume preparation and review, and job placement assistance. H2K Infosys is trusted by so many students across the world. H2K Infosys provides world-class services in IT training with real-time project work for corporates and individuals, special IT training for MS students in the United States, software design, development, QA manual and automation, performance testing and maintenance, IT staff augmentation, job placement assistance and tech support.
Copy here, why should I request her, you know, please give me permission to read my own book? I need not do that, right? Okay, then keyword view. If you look here, click on the test flow. All the files are ready for you. Open order is there, login is there, logout is there. Okay. Do you see here logout is from which file? Neha file. It is very clearly appearing. Is it clear? Pavni, making reusable is very simple. Right click, action properties, click on this reusable action, it becomes reusable. Okay. Alright, so we have all three. But do you see the order is not good here? Open order first and then login, then logout. We got to arrange it. Yes, of course we have to arrange. Otherwise QTP will start, you know, with the open order and it will not find that flight reservation. It will start giving you the error. Okay. So I take this copy of login. One second, okay. I have low battery. It will get disconnected otherwise. I'll just get connected to my battery. Okay. I mean, not my battery. My battery doesn't go down anytime. It is only my laptop battery that goes down. Okay. So we have the copy of login over here. Okay. Nalini is asking the question for the first time. Okay. Yes, Nalini, we are going to have this recording session which I will send you. Okay. This is the first time that, you know, you have asked the question to me. I'm so glad. Okay. So I drag it. Okay. Let me show it very clearly. Just observe everybody. Okay. Look at my screen very carefully. Observe it. What I'm going to do now. Select this copy of login. I want it where? Before the open order. Select it. Drag it very carefully to the top. Release it using your mouse. So the sequence is set now. Is it in the correct sequence? Copy of login, open order, logout. Okay. What next? So much of work we have done. Now we got to run and see it. See, drag and drop. Select it and you can drag and drop anywhere. Okay. Let me show again. This open order, I want to push it on the top, select and drag it. Do you see? It gets dragged. Okay. You need a bit of practice over here, otherwise you will end up, you know, like putting it here somewhere in between. You should not do it. Do it very carefully. Okay. And slowly. Alright. Then what next? As usual, run. But before that, let me close this reservation application, otherwise it will give me error. Click on run button. Shall we put some wait so that we are able to observe? Okay. I've put the wait. Then after open order, again I'll put one wait. Okay. It is just because, you know, we can observe it. I hope everybody knows what is the purpose of wait. I'm just introducing some delay so that we can observe it very clearly. Okay. Then click on run. And observe the results. Okay, my QTP has got slow, but anyways, you know, finally it executes. Okay, agent name is open, then it is typing in. Okay, so it logged in. The first action got executed. This is my second action, which is open order. It is trying to open the order number 5. Lastly, it logged out. Okay, let's wait for the result window to come up. This is the result window. Okay. And here, if I expand this, do you see? What can you see here? Copy of login is there. Open order summary is there. Logout is there. All of them are, you know, like separately displayed over here. You see? In the sequence. We have the copy of login and all the same steps. Okay, they are appearing here. Then we have the open order. And then we have the flight reservation. Is it clear? Okay. Fine. Now I know what should be your next question. Some of you might feel it is confusing. No, it is not confusing. It is only lengthy. I can do it in just 5 minutes. If you have a practice, you can just do it in 5 minutes. Okay. We are going slow so that you know understand step by step. Okay. And it is lengthy a bit, but not at all difficult to understand. Okay. Now what you do is, right from the beginning, whatever we did for this reusable action, write the steps. Take 5 minutes and then write all these steps. Lavanya, ignore these, okay? These are the recovery actions that I was teaching in my previous classes. Okay, so you can ignore those. Okay. Fine. Now what you got to do is, whatever we did till now, okay, whatever we did till now, you are going to write the steps in your own words. Like step 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You got to write the steps right from the beginning. Will you do it right away? Go ahead, do it. Okay. Swarna, in the QTP 11 also it is same. Right click, go to the action properties. And then you can add the reusability over there. Or you can cancel the reusability. Okay. Angelina, new action is the same. Okay, in case my action is not created. If you see here in both the cases, the login and logout I had created in advance, right? So in case I had not created it, then I'll say call new action. Means it will start recording again. Okay, it is better, you know, we create and keep it and then reuse it. It is like, you know, Lavanya is going to ask the book and then Neha starts purchasing it. Correct? No, Anita, it is not difficult, okay? See, you need little bit of practice, otherwise it is fine. Okay? And of course, you know, if the things are little bit hard and you learn it, then only you get some value over there. If it would have been so simple, then, you know, there would be no job opportunities for us. Everybody would have come to IT, you know, and everybody would have like, it would be like so much rush and so much of competition. So harder the things, lesser the competition. That's good. Okay, take 2 minutes and I will take 2 minutes of rest. You got to write all the steps. Okay, done Prerna? Everybody is done? Okay, Pavni, you have written so lengthy steps. Okay, no problem. Okay, do one thing Prerna. Okay, I will unmute you and you know you got to tell all the steps to everybody. Okay? Wait, let me unmute you. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, go ahead.
Yeah, first we have to make the first script in which we'll record the login and logout. So we'll go to the flight app and record the login and logout steps. Then we'll stop it, the script is in the recording mode. Now what we'll do is that with the first script, we will take the cursor after all the login steps are finished and we will click on, on split action, and because we want to divide it into separate actions, and we'll name it as login, and then we'll do the similar activity for logout. Now we have for the first script we have two separate sections. The very first one is the login and the other one is the logout. We have done this so that we can use them separately wherever needed. Now what we will do is that also we want this logout to be the reusable one. So what we will do that we will make it reusable by right clicking it, then selecting action properties, and then checking the reusable action checkbox. So that rounded sign will start appearing on logout, which means that it is reusable. Okay. So now we are done with our first script. What we will do is that we will now record the another script, that is open order. We do not need to record the login and logout activities because that has already been covered in the first script. So now we'll record the script open order, and then we'll do the recording with all the necessary steps that are required, and then stop the recording. Now we have the open order script in place. Now what we will do is that we have only the open order. Now we want the login functionality and the logout. So what we will use is that before the open order steps, we will use the function call to copy of action, and we will select this login. We have to select the first of all we have to select the script name, that is our first script, which I have named it as login and logout, and then we have to I have to select the action, that is login I will select, and then also I'll select the radio button, that is at the end of the test, and then click on the OK button. So now I have login in my this script, second script, that is open order, and then at the end after the open order steps are completed, at the bottom I'll use the call to existing function, and then we'll select my script one name, that is login and logout, and then I'll select the logout action, and then also the similarly this radio button. So now I have after this I have my open order in place with all the necessary actions, that is login, open order, and logout, and then I'll like reorder them, and then now my script is in place, so I can execute it.
Okay, thank you, Prerna.
Hey, Priya, I'm done.
Okay. Thank you, Prerna.
Okay. So what are the steps that we follow? The first step that we had to follow was, okay, we had to record. I will write the steps here again briefly. Okay, here. What are the steps that we had to follow? First thing is we will be creating the file one, wherein we are creating the login, logout. Okay, this is step number one. Step number two is we got to split this one into two actions. Step number three is we got to make the logout as reusable because we want to use the call to existing method there. Step number four is we got to record our file two, wherein we have to record the open order. then step number 5 is we got to import the login and logout here, and then also set the sequence. Okay, that's it. Execute. Is it clear, everybody? We have the login and logout, then we got to split it, make it reusable, create the open order, and then call the two of them over here, set the sequence, execute. 6 steps only. Clear, everybody? And do you see here, for the global, there is one sheet, open order, copy of action, and then logout. Since there are 3 actions, there are 3 sheets over here. And then we have the global here. Okay? Clear, everybody? All right? Okay. Now, okay. Somebody had asked me to unmute. Yes, it was Lavanya. Lavanya, I will unmute you and you can ask the question. And after that, Pavni, right? Okay. Lavanya, tell me, what is your question?
Yeah, Priya, my question was, why do we have to split the action? I mean, now I understood the whole concept, but earlier, since we have written, if you go to the expert view after recording the login and logout, the thing, since you have already made the comments, right? So I was just asking then, why do we have to split the action?
Okay, now is it clear?
Yeah, now it is clear.
Okay.
But when do we, what kind of situation do we use it, so that we don't have to log in and log out all the time?
Okay, I will tell you the real-time situation now, where exactly we do this. Okay, Pavni is also good now. Okay, fine. Hold on, I'll tell you the real-time situation. In the real-time, what happens, there will be many testers, correct? To test this one single application, we will be having many testers. And testing each of the different modules will be assigned to the different people. Let's say this flight reservation will be tested by Lavanya, and then the open order, and then we have the delete. Some of the features will be tested by, let's say, Pavni. Okay. Some other features will be tested by other person. Okay. So like this, in the team, the different functionalities or the different modules will be assigned to the different people, correct? Now everybody needs that login, okay? So if everybody starts recording the same login, there can be two consequences. It is going to waste everybody's time and effort.
So many of our students have given testimonials on how our training programs are. You will find them on kudzu.com and on our website h2kinfosys.com. On our website h2kinfosys.com, you will also find more detailed information on who we are, the courses that we offer, what each course covers. Also, if you're interested in a demo program, please register on our homepage on the left-hand side. Just give us more information about yourself and we will send you a link for a demo class. The demo class is absolutely free. Experience our commitment by just attending an orientation workshop at no cost. Our team of faculty and advisors are here to guide you with the right information. If you still have more questions, please feel free to call us. Call us at 770-777-1269. This is a United States number. If you're calling from the UK, call us at 020-337-17615. You can also email us at training@h2kinfosys.com or h2kinfosys@gmail.com. Thank you. thank you for watching our videos. We wish you a great career in information technology.